Hey boys, hey girls. Welcome back to Louisiana Cajun recipes and our Italian kitchen. Today I'm going to make some Bracciole. And I made this before, it's been about 6 years ago, and they're delicious. I'm going to take a little different twist on them this time. I'm putting some ham and bacon inside with cheeses and onions, mushrooms, Trinity in other words, and garlic. And you can stuff these with all kind of things. I mean, it's a little meat roll. They're kind of a pain because you got to roll them up and either toothpick them or wrap them with butcher's twine or silicone rubber bands like I have. We've also made some conchiglia. Long time ago also, had to get Miss JB to help me. That's them large pasta shells that are stuffed with meat. And we made cannelloni. And all of those are real good. I like Italian. I like any kind of damn food, actually. So we'll get started with this. And there's a bunch of different kind of meats you can use, too. You can use flank steak, for instance. I've got some really thin cut top round, I believe it is. They're really, really thin, like cut for Milanesa. Anyway. But they'd be good. So we get started. Alright, I got some just kind of rough chopped Italian flat leaf. Do remove the bigger stems, they're bitter. The little small stems, like that one there, it'd be alright. You won't notice it. I sauteed down some Trinity, garlic, got some mushrooms in there, some Black Forest ham, any ham you want, it don't matter. I wouldn't use that sweet honey ham, though. And bacon, crisp bacon that I fried and crumbled into this. Let's put our parsley mixture. Come on, get off my fingers. Damn it, boy. We need some breadcrumbs. Because all the recipes I've seen call for it. I don't know why, but they do. All right, now it's in there. Got to open this. And this is Parmesan cheese. Open up, my fingers are wet. Damn it. Stand by. Success. All right, I put about a half a cup of this in there. Two. Heaping. Yum. I'm going to put some mozzarella. Like I already stated, you can put any damn thing in here you want. Just don't put your dog in there. Get out the way. Got some mozzarella. Put that in there too. Let's mix all this up. It's gonna be our stuffing. Let's mix it up good. We'll get our meat ready after I wrench my hands in the zinc. Damn it. Okay, so here we go. Already made one. Let's put some filling in there. Like I should have made some more filling. We ended up with more steak than I got filling. Fold the edges in. And then roll your own. We go fry. that's going to toothpick them. Tying knots in that, that's going to be hard for me. I'm all thumbs, yeah. That's the word. All right, good. Got two made. Let me continue. And you can put these in the refrigerator, cook them tomorrow, or cook them later. We're going to cook them now, though. Let me get done rolling them. Rolling my own. All right. So gently put some in there, but don't overload the pan. And try to keep your fingers out the hot oil. Ow. Got them flipped. Be careful with them, they'll come apart. Unless you use twine on them. You talk about gonna be good, yeah. Oh boy! Once they're nice and brown, carefully remove them. We'll start another batch. This is that last one that don't have too much filling in it. Look, you can get the sides and stuff right by tilting your pan and keeping it over the fire. And just keep doing this till everything's fried up nice like you like it. Now, prop. It's when you're removing them, put them seam side down in the pan you're going to cook them in. We'll finish these in. I should be using a spatula, but I ain't. Okay. Now we don't need that no more. Well, let's go. I put some butter in here. This is a pan that I cooked the Trinity in. I add some more mushrooms. Is this dish fattening? Could be. Now let's hit them with a little wine. Oops. Oops. Good. Let that reduce some. Now, if you don't want wine, you could, if you don't drink wine, you could make a vodka cream sauce for this. And that's very good. This would be good, too. You stupid camera. It wasn't recording. Sorry. I added some of my homemade marinara sauce with the wine and the mushrooms and the butter. And we're going to let this come up to heat. Pour it over here, over the meat, and bake that in the oven for about 2 hours on 300. During the last 30 minutes or so, we'll uncover it, to evaporate any last little bits. And I think I got some tortellini that I bought at the store, some three cheese tortellini, and we'll serve it with that in the sauce. And the yum. Serve it with what you want. You can make risotto if you wanted to, or what's that other one? That cornbread stuff.
Polenta.
Yeah, you can serve it over polenta too. Yum. Let's go ahead and pour this over the meat. I'm gonna add a little bit of water to this because it's pretty thick. I reduced it a bit too much. So now let's go ahead and cover this and put it in the oven. And remember that a glass pan will cook hotter than a metal pan. So that's why we're gonna bake this at about 300. If you could use a metal pan or pot, you can do it at about 350. So here's what I got. And I'm just gonna follow the directions. On the back. There we go. We got that pasta stuff, yeah. The stuff with cheese. Right? Right. These are meat rolls. And they are ready. See them down there? Let's get a couple of them out of there. Yum. Whoa, you're getting crazy over here. It'll be all right. If you can use flank steak, go to full 2 hours, but for this thin a cut, I mean, they were just falling apart almost. And it is very, very rich. I mean, I was so full, I was hurting after eating like 3 of them. So maybe it was them tortellinis with the cheese stuffing also. And then we had to have some garlic bread too. You know that, huh? Oh, hell yeah. There it is, a little picture of it. Young boy, a girl, a bye.